Welcome to the World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Day. As Secretary General of the International Federation for Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus, I'm sending you the best wishes from our head office in Brussels. Each year on October the 25th, we celebrate the World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Day. And during this day, our members and partners worldwide come together to raise awareness about Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. It also serves as means to advocate and promote the rights of persons with these conditions and showcase the strengths of individuals with SBH, their families, and healthcare providers. The right to health in accordance with Article 25 of the UNCRPD is a high priority for IF and the global SBH community. Access to timely diagnosis, to information, treatment, and multidisciplinary care is still unattainable for many in the global SBH community. With stigma, discrimination, and lack of awareness creating even further barriers to the enjoyment of the highest attainable standard of health. The barriers may vary between communities and individuals, but the goal of advancing the right to health for all individuals with SBH remains the same. Therefore, we share with you this year's theme for the World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus, which is Unlock Your Right to Health. As state parties to the convention, the government, healthcare centers, and parent associations can really inspire to respect and implement these principles. I have the full confidence that together with you, as important advocates here today, it will inspire the many activities and events going forward.
Hello, my name is Rasmus Isaacson, and I'm a member of the board of the International Federation for Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. I would like to welcome and encourage all of you to participate in the World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Day on the 25th of October. The aim of this day is to raise awareness and understanding about Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. This day also aims to improve the rights of persons with these conditions. I'm also a member of the Swedish Organization for Persons with Spina Bifida, SPINOFF. SPINOFF is one of many local organizations around the world that is working to improve the quality of life of persons with Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus of all ages and to raise awareness about our rights. One of those rights is the right to health, and this year's theme is Unlock Your Right to Health. As I grow older, I have found that it is something that needs extra attention, and a better health really makes my everyday life much easier and gives me much more opportunities in life. For example, when it comes to employment. But in order to improve our rights to health, we also need to improve other aspects of society, such as accessibility, for example. I don't know what I would do without being able to drive my own car to my accessible gym and work out every day. That is life equality to me. So I send my best wishes to all Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus communities for a successful World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Day 2021. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Sonia Uribe. I am from Colombia. I am the director of the unique institution in Colombia involved with the Spina Bifida. Today I am here to make a very special invitation. 25 of October is the day of the World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalia Day. We are going together to work for the right of for your health. Everybody have the right for your health. So let's go to work together and let's go to enjoy that day and to say to the world, Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalia families are working together. Thank you.
My name is Hassan Fumilayo. And
my name is Samara Fumilayo.
We are welcoming you all to the World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Day 2021. And we are members of Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Association. I'm also the acting president for SBAN, Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Association in Nigeria. The theme for this year couldn't have come at a much better time back here in Nigeria. Unlock your right to health. Currently, as we speak, doctors are on strike, which means all our members, all our children living with hydrocephalus and spina bifida can't access healthcare. Imagine this scenario that we are facing right now. Newborn babies born with hydrocephalus can't go through their surgeries. Those who are born with spina bifida can't have their spina bifida closed. You can imagine what it means to these people who need immediate health care. So our right to health has to be unlocked. It could have come at a much better time. We are now using this medium to say happy World Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Day to all. Bye.
Desde Argentina le damos la bienvenida a la nueva edición de celebración del Día Mundial de la Espina Bífida y la hidrocefalia. Este año, el lema del Día Internacional de la Espina Bífida y la Hidrocefalia tiene que ver con desbloquear el derecho a la salud. Y qué importante que es eso, ¿no? Para todos nosotros, especialmente, poder garantizarnos el derecho a la salud es, sin duda, asegurarnos una mejor calidad de vida y, por sobre todas las cosas, es asegurarnos que dejemos de ser invisibles en ese aspecto de nuestra vida cotidiana. Poder acceder a la salud, sin duda, nos asegura una mayor inclusión a nivel social. APEBI, Asociación para Espina Bífida e Hidrocefalia, es una asociación que en la República Argentina tiene más de 40 años de existencia y de trayectoria en el ámbito de la discapacidad, y desde sus inicios brega por la inclusión de las personas con esta discapacidad en nuestro país y, por sobre todas las cosas, nos brinda a nosotros como personas con discapacidad y a nuestras familias acompañamiento, contención y todo tipo de asesoramiento necesario para que nuestra calidad de vida a lo largo de los años sea la mejor posible. En este Día Mundial de la Espina Bífida y la Hidrocefalia, desde la República Argentina, deseamos que las personas con discapacidad todos los días podamos seguir ganando derechos, podamos sentirnos cada vez más incluidos en nuestras sociedades y, por sobre todas las cosas, podamos vivir una vida plena, feliz y, por sobre todas las cosas, autónoma e independiente.
I'm Patrick Esuman and I'm the Executive Director for RECMIS Foundation. RECMIS Foundation is a non-governmental organization in Ghana that seeks to advocate and create awareness about spina bifida and hydrocephalus. We are the organization that is addressing issues that is relating to spina bifida and hydrocephalus in Ghana. I am happy to hear that the national organization has picked right to health as the theme for 2021 World Hydrocephalus and Spina Bifida Day. In fact, I am so happy for the team because right to health is one issue that persons with spina bifida and hydrocephalus are facing, especially here in Ghana. When we talk about right to health, we are talking about equality and equity in health delivery. There are certain health conditions that has been able to have equal or adequate health care in Ghana, but I come to tell you that Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus has been left out when it comes to health care delivery in Ghana. One factor is the misunderstanding of the condition here in Ghana. I come to tell you that there is less knowledge on Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus in Ghana when it comes to research base. As it stands now, even our country do not have the adequate information or database on Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. So how can a government come out a policy for persons with Spina Bifida if they do not have much adequate information about the condition or database of the condition? And these are factors that is leading to not having equal right to health. Now, because of that, most policies that are passed by the government do not favor persons with Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. Talking of the National Health Insurance Scheme that Ghana has, persons with Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus has no better provision in the National Health Insurance Scheme. So with the treatment of Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus has been a great challenge for mothers or caretakers that have children with the condition. So the only option that they have is one to lay on NGOs to come and support our individuals. If not, they leave their child to die or to go on the street to beg for alms. Another factor is the knowledge of the health professionals when it comes to management of Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. So you find out that it got a point the health professionals do not have the requisite knowledge in managing the condition. So the child is left with where they have been able to manage it to, and making most of them to live with all forms of disabilities, severe disabilities. Health system is not favorable for persons with Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus in Ghana. So I am happy that the International Federation is looking at exploring the barriers that is hindering accessing health care for persons with Spina Bifida. And we are looking at the right to health. I'm happy, and I urge all members to contribute their best to make sure that this become a national topic or a worldwide topic, so that we push it to make policies and people in authority to come on board to bring up policies that will go on to favor persons with Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. I wish all persons with Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus happy Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Day. And we urge all of them to come together, join effort with the International Federation, local and the national organization, to push this theme so that we will be able to change policy and influence policy in Ghana or across the world. Thank you very much. Bye.
Hello, my name is Judy Feely, and welcome to all WSBHD participants. I am a member of Hydrocephalus Canada. What Unlock Your Right to Health means to me is that all people, regardless of whether they have a disability or not, have access to quality health care, which includes physical, mental, and social aspects to it. I also want to wish you good luck on Spina Bifida Hydrocephalus Day, which is October 25th.
Yes, and you are right to health. Central Uganda Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Network welcomes you to the 2050 day October of 2021. We are celebrating the World Spina Bifida Day with the theme, Unlock Your Potential, Your Right to Health. We are very happy to see everyone around the world celebrating the World Spina Bifida Day of 2021. The theme, Unlock Your Right to Health, means a lot to our children's health. who have been with challenges all over the world, because not many people have known about spina bifida yet. But now that we have unlocked the right for everybody to be healthy, this time I'm sure the world will have a smile. The World Spina Bifida Day is always celebrated on the 25th of October. It was begun by the International Federation for Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus. And in 2012, and up to today, we still celebrate that day because we want our children's rights to be protected. And we all have to advocate for their rights. So on this day, we always come out to the world to explain more about spina bifida and hydrocephalus to you. Can you help celebrate with us? Our theme again, unlock your right to health. Best wishes from Central Uganda Spina Bifida and Hydrocephalus Network, Uganda.
Hi, I'm Professor Dr. Amara Naikanesaduri. I'm a consultant rehabilitation physician at Hospital University Kebangsaan, Malaysia. I have been caring for persons with spina bifida for almost 20 years. I'm also the current president of Spina Bifida Association of Malaysia, otherwise known as CBM. CBM is a non-profit organization whose main objective is to look after the interests of children and adults with spina bifida and its related disorders. As we gain more support, we also face more challenges as the pandemic has peeled out yet another layer of issues to be surmounted, with increasing need for support for our members for social and mental health issues, financial issues stemming from unemployment, healthcare issues from interrupted health services, and of course, our own perennial struggle to raise funds to meet much of their needs. And so, we still have much to do.
Unlock your right to health. My name is Andrej and I'm from Slovakia. Hello. In 1997 was born our son Dominic with spina bifida and hydrocephalus. In that time we knew very little about the defect and what to expect from the life. We learned to enjoy every single day as a gift. Based on experiences from the IF World Conferences, especially Oslo 2004, we understood that only if we do something, it will make difference. Since we founded the organization, we made a lot of things which leads to network creating between professionals, doctors, nurses, parents, and children. We invested time into the prevention. But as children grew up, we start to understand their personal development needs, which leads to their future independence. We understood that each today is about tomorrow. I wish that every single day you may emphasize as a very unique day, which may bring you to independence and future. What the world's day for spina bifida and hydrocephalus means for me, I will kindly rephrase the wording as follows. Unlock your hands and mind to the right to grow. Never give up. Take care of yourself, your friends, your closest, your present, and your future. Thank you and bye.